Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is resource group in Azure. So before getting into this topic, if you're new to this channel and haven't subscribed this channel yet, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Azure and anything related to data and analytics. Let's begin our today's topic. So resource group, the definition says like, it is a container that holds related resources for an Azure solution. So in Azure, we said like most of the things whatever you create is considered as resources. So as the name indicates, it groups all those resources. It's just a container. So that is what a resource group is all about. And in other terms, we can consider it as it can include all resources for the solution or only those resources that you want to manage as a group. So how you can differentiate is like, it can be like based on different functional areas, or you can consider it as for development environment, you create one resource group. So whatever you create under this group, which will be used for the development environment. And you can also create the production or UAT different resource group in that way. And in some other case where resource group can be used is like you want to create resource group for different departments. So it basically grouping of your resources so that it will be useful for your billing or it can be used for managing your applications. So either way, this is very useful. Let's try to understand this architecture. Now, as I said before, whatever you create in Azure, that should belong to some resource group. And internally, in turn, like this resource group connected to a subscription and Azure account attached to it. So in our previous video, we have already created Azure account and a free subscription for us. Then today we are going to see how to create a resource group. Then any of the resources we can able to create it. So this is the hierarchy. As you can see in the diagram, Azure account can have also access to some other subscription as well. So then coming to underneath, you have a different resource group as well. So this is the hierarchy, you can see it here. And as you can see, this resource group contains three resources. One is virtual machine, some functions, web apps. This particular resource group contains only the SQL. So it depends upon how you organize the things. That is what a simple definition about resource group. And let's move on to Azure portal. Then we will quickly create one resource group now. I already in Azure portal where we have already navigated what are the different options available here. Now there comes a resource group. So before creating a resource group, if you try to create some SQL or whatever, we said like it will prompt for resource group, right? So it is always good practice to create the resource group first. First things are first, so let's create one. So resource group, once you click on it, it will list down all the resource group. As I'm creating it for the very first time, there is nothing is listed. Let us create one by clicking on create. Once you click on create, then it will prompt for subscription. It is again a free subscription we have now. Then provide your name. I will always recommend a proper naming convention for this resource groups. So AWN, then I can say like AWN Azure Data Solutions, right? Azure DS course, whatever. Just make it short like this. So AWN Azure DS is the resource group, and you can always prefix with resource group something or G or whatever naming convention. The region is also something important this is very important in case like once you create your resource group, your resources can, if you change the resources in some other region, then it becomes very complex. So you need to keep everything, the resource group, resources, everything in the same region, so there won't be any much latencies. Now let us go for default US East US, and it depends upon your organization rules. You want to keep everything within your country, then you need to follow those rules as well. that is something like tags. This is very helpful when you want to use it for billing or some other purpose, like tags. You understand it, right? This is dev or production, something like that. So for those things, the tags will be useful. We will learn more about it. That is nothing much about the tags. Then once you are done, just giving what we have given, we have chosen the subscription, provided the name, region is important. Then click on review and create. That's it. So validation passed, then you click on create. So as I said before, now you see like the notification tab, the resource group created, right? So this is what it is. We have seen last time, everything, whatever we do in Azure, that will be notified here. Now you can see the resource group, one of the resource group available. Then now we will start creating some resources here. Let's say like create one virtual machine. Be with me. So virtual machine, just click on it, then click on create. So I'm creating one resource like virtual machine VM. And again, you can see here, we have renamed here. I mean to say whatever we created, that will appear. So all the resources you create should be tagged under one resource group. So this resource group is first, things are first. So you need to understand it. Just it's a grouping. That is what we have. Then you can provide your name here, like virtual machine. Again, I'm saying like AWN, Azure, data solutions, learning. Then you provide your VM name, like VM for learning. That's it. So Linux VM names may contain, so this is Linux VM. So it is asking for some other naming convention. Let's try to create another name. So Windows VM names may not contain underscore. So this is another important concept, like some of the naming will be allowing, for some of the objects it will allow underscore, for some of the things it will not allow underscore. That we will take it up later. Then this is the thing, then you can provide your username, password and confirm password. This will allow, there are a lot of options. We can keep going on other properties over here, but to make you to understand what we are doing, like whatever resources you create, that will ask for the resource group. Let's quickly try to provide a username, and it also has some rules. So AWN, I will say like Azure Data Solutions. That's it. So the administrator is this one. I will provide some strong password. Okay, I provided the password now, then public input bounds. This is not relevant to us. I mean, I'm not going to do anything with that. Just I'm trying to create a resources now, one new resource, like I want a virtual machine. And in that, I have tagged that resource group, right? There are a lot of properties I need to set in order to efficiently work with this virtual machine, but I'm not going for that. Now you can see the pricing also, how much pricing it is, very negligible price, like even not even $1, like 0.1880 USD per hour. That is the pricing for the standard configurations. Let us try to create one, and then we can understand how it works. Now you can see in the notification pane, initializing deployment, where as we saw here, resource group creation is very quick, but creating a virtual machine taking long time. So now you can see here our virtual server is created. It is so quick, like now you can see here in your home, whatever recently you did. Now we have this virtual machine underneath. You can go and check it out here. This is your, now what I'm trying to say is, when you go to your resource group, it will list you the different options here. AWN. Under this, you can see what are the different objects available. You can see AWN DS virtual machine is available. And once you create a virtual machine along with other service, what are the prerequisites, everything required also will be created for you. You are not doing anything. I hope now you understand about this concept behind it. We have created a resource group. Underneath, we have created one resource as well. That is the main agenda. We are not going to log in or searching this one. That is another topic. But now the main purpose is whatever you create in Azure Azure resources, everything will be tagged under resource group. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.